There was a lady I met in my travels of real estate, lived in Apple Valley, went to list her house, walked through, did the initial walkthrough, and this odor, overwhelming. Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. Welcome to Housing Radio. You can find us on Facebook, facebook.com/housingradio, and Twitter, if you tweet, at Housing Radio. I'm, of course, Connor McIver, your host, housingradio.com, and today is our real estate show, January 29th, 2016. We opened up our Facebook page yesterday, finally had it finished, and you can check that out. facebook.com/housingradio. One of the things I would like to do this morning, because of all the followers that hit us up so quickly, I am honored. Brian Lafferty, Chris Lessing, Sean Line, Paula Feifel, Mickey Gonzalez, Deborah Cabtree, Manazarian, Debbie Drummond, Keith Ortiz, Dan Seam, Cheryl Fatul, Jamie Lynn Lessing, Tony Grudardo, Robert Montoya, Estrella Davis, Karen Holt Highland, Michael Joseph Hurtado, Jessica Martinez, Steve Duncan, Tim Lovett, Tony Lewis, Lisa Bonham, David Paul, Chris Fisher, Jeanette Yamamoto, Maribel Benitez, Jessica Pisano, Bob Quinn, Kurt Smith, Carlos Avalos, Anita Gallander, Mark DeMuccia, Gail Stargard, Ray Hollenbeck, Yvette Burden, Jason Merrick, Chris Schaus, Roberto Murphy, Karen Wayne, Don Gebbard, Michael Chupa, Kelly Anderson, Stacey Ball, Don Zerbel, Pam Green, Love to Ride, Cal Fitt, that's Aaron, Robin Finchel, Sherry Cook Scales, Mike Young, John McCarthy, Taylor Weiner, Elias Nathaniel, John Stargard, Ryan Blickier, Jesse Lucero, Charlene Mullen, Tricia Barnes, Mary Shales, Fernando De La Torre, Sam Martin, Ernest Jeter, Helena Diamond, Maya Robinson, and Brian Hollenbaugh. Everybody, thank you so much. Let's get to today's show. Now, what I want to talk about, a couple things. Of course, today is our Finale Friday broadcast. This is where we're looking at the 29th day of January, show number 2016-029. And by the way, if I continue to do this Facebook thing, we might put it at the end of the show. But that was fun. And if I slaughtered your name, sorry about that. I'm sincerely sorry. More about Housing Radio. Now, we have the Twitter, at Housing Radio. Facebook, Housing Radio, housingradio.com, that exists as well. That's where we have all our past episodes. Now, recap, 70 new properties hit in this last week, Santa Clarita Valley. And everybody says, well, Connor, you guys are not just in Santa Clarita Valley. Yeah, I get that. But what Santa Clarita is a small snapshot of the other local markets. When we report on Santa Clarita's numbers, you'll see those same ratios existing in the other markets. San Fernando Valley, Simi Valley, L.A. You're going to see all of it in Rancho Cucamonga, Pomona, Pacoima, wherever you're looking, you're going to see that kind of an idea. And here's what I mean. Of the listings out there on the market for sale, total 957, only 490 are active. We were just a little bit above 500. Last several months, I saw 550s, 600, but now we're down to 490. Where's that extra inventory? Well, people are worried, especially buyers out there, and there's a lot of those, my fellow agents can attest to, buyers out there looking for homes for sale, and they're not finding the inventory, and they're getting distraught. So they're trying to do it themselves by going around to open houses. And again, as my fellow agents can attest to, be careful with that whole open house thing, and be careful what you're signing. It's kind of an anonymity type thing. But if an agent at open house is insisting, saying their sellers are insisting, you know what, whatever. Let them know you have an agent, and it'll be like you just put a crucifix up to the forehead of a vampire. They'll back away. They'll just move away rather quickly. That's advice. Looking at this 490 total, of the 957 total, 490 are active, 243 in backup, 224 in pending. That's horrible. Great for real estate sellers, definitely a seller's market. We're anywhere from 10 to 12% off peak, at least for December's closing figures in 2015. We'll see what January brings us as soon as we close this month out and start compiling that real estate data. So come back to that show. And of course, I said housingradio.com. For these new ones, scvnest.com, you can see all of that intel there as well. Steve Duncan, a friend of ours on Facebook, friend of ours not just on Facebook. He came yesterday. He was talking about, I did a show yesterday about, and in each show we do tips, seller tips, buyer tips. This one's kind of going to be a combination seller and buyer. And if you think my voice is sexy, that's because I'm still have a cold, trying to get over it, but it's not done yet. And I know Yoda says do or do not, but here we go. I'm going to do it. I'm going to get over this cold. I went into the doctor's office yesterday. They took great care of me on Lyons. Saw Tim Olson, old friend of mine. Anyway, motor cop. Back to it. So he says, you know, let's do a show on sense. I say, you know what? That makes a lot of sense. You walk into a property as a real estate buyer, you smell overwhelming cherry or apple or pine or cookies or cinnamon. You know, those smells. The plug-in air freshener smells, or the whole bunch of candles on the desk smells like we're about to take a romantic bath with rose petals smells. What it means is this. Most real estate buyers say, and they ask me, boy, it sure is smell potent in here. What happens, those types of air fresheners try to mask. While if your house is neutral, and you're not going to know this until you have somebody come into it, you're used to the way your home smells. If it smells funky, you're used to funky. It's not until you have somebody come in that's never smelled your house before to give you an opinion. Well, and as long as that person has a good smeller, they'll come into your house, they'll give you an opinion, and that could be the real estate agent. But let's say you're a smoker in your house, the real estate agent is a smoker in your house, or a smoker in life, they might not notice as much of the smell when they walk into your house. For them, everywhere they go might smell like Vegas. Back to your home, you want to make sure that you don't have that issue. That's how buyers are looking at it. As a seller, you definitely don't want the buyers to look at it that way. As a real estate buyer, you definitely want to be curious as to what people are trying to cover up. What might this be? Is it pets? Back to the beginning of the show when I spoke about the Apple Valley lady and that listing, I smelled cats when I first went in. Nothing against animals, but I smelled cats. And it was pretty ripe as I'm walking around, pretty ripe. Besides asking that question, what are they covering up? On a seller's side, you don't want the buyer asking those questions. The recommendation is this. Whenever you're trying to get your house prepared for sale, of course, always call that local expert. Give us a call. You're out here in Santa Clarita, elsewhere in Southern California. You have somebody else that you love and you trust. Call them. No big deal. Bottom line, Febreze. Febreze. That's the tip. Febreze. The reason being, if you do any kind of research on Febreze, I don't remember exactly where I heard this. It was in some book. They were talking about the development of that chemical, Febreze, and what it was originally engineered for and what it ended up doing. It's like the cat with the microwave. Remember, he wasn't setting out to find a warming up device. And if some of our clients are listening and they swear off of microwaves, they never touch them. I'm not saying this is an endorsement for microwaves, but you get what I'm saying. But he started out with something else. He was looking for, I forgot what, and then all of a sudden he finds something that doesn't cover, but neutralizes. Actually bonds with the odor-causing mechanism and doesn't allow it to be smelled anymore. Very simple way to put it. That's what Febreze does. So back to Apple Valley and this lady, the smell, while it was in the other parts of her home, it was being generated from a single room. And when yours truly went into that room, yours truly, it was so overwhelming, even breathing through my mouth wasn't helping. So, 16 cats later, and they were all in the room. That was the potty break room, apparently. There must have been 7 or 8 containers of the cat litter in that room. And, you know, I'm sure she tried. The room didn't look disheveled. There were a lot of cats in there, and yours truly a little allergic. I think we talked about that. So I could just feel my throat starting to close up and my eyes starting to swell shut. As we're in the room, she says, "So what do you think? How can I make this room better?" I said, "Well, let me tell you. If we're going to list your house for a sale, you got to get rid of the smell." And she says, "Smell it? It doesn't smell that bad." I said, "You're used to it. You're completely used to the smell of your home. But me not being an animal owner at the present time, smell it as I'm walking up the stairs. And especially in this room, you'll never be able to sell this house to anybody. You're going to have to get rid of those smells. So we're going to have to start with a cleaning. You're going to have to start with using a lot of Febreze." When I went back a couple weeks later, and again, it's a neutralizing agent. We're not talking about failing to disclose, because that's very important for sellers. On the disclosures, it's going to talk about pets. It's going to ask if you have any Mr. and Mrs. Sellers of the world. You're going to put them down. And if you happen to have had three types of dogs, three different breeds over the time you live there, put down each different breed. You never want to leave anything out. If it was a German Shepherd and a Beagle and a Shar Pei, put them all down as having been in the residence while you were there. If you had a tenant-occupied property that we're trying to sell for you, also put down if they had pets and you don't know the type, at least indicate that they had pets while they were renting your property. That's super important, folks. Some people have allergies. Some people, if you don't feel bad for them, some people have kids that have severe allergic reactions to pets and pet odors and the remnants of pets. It's important. But that's what we recommend, Febreze. The chocolate chip cookies are great, awesome. People love the smell. It makes people feel warm and cozy. But that's a seller and buyer tip what to look for when it comes to approaching real estate. Of course, I'm Connor McIver. This has been HousingRadio.com, a presentation of our real estate team here at RE/MAX. Local agents, Santa Clarita Valley, serving greater Los Angeles, Southern California. God bless you people for liking our page on Facebook. All the people that I mentioned at the beginning of the show. Again, thank you all. I am Connor with Honor. We'll be back tomorrow with our Sold Saturdays broadcast and some more buyer and seller tips. Can't wait to talk to you. Past episodes, HousingRadio.com. You'll listen to them all and hear my wonderfully sexy voice. Connor McIver over and out.